Here are 5 reasons that I see people failing at selling on Amazon. Hey, I'm Paul, and I'm committed to teaching you the exact strategies I use to create multiple 6-figure businesses on eBay and Amazon. These are the same methods that changed my life, and I'm here to show you how they can change yours as well. So before we get started, this video is actually being sponsored, so I wanted to thank the sponsor, who is Payability. You'll be hearing more about them in a few minutes, but I wanted to give them a shout out for helping make this video possible. So the first reason, and actually the number one reason that I see people failing on Amazon, is because they get too impatient and they give up way too early. Amazon has a reputation to maintain. They are a business. They want to make sure that every seller on their platform is a good, reputable seller. So it takes time to scale a store because it takes time to gain Amazon's trust. You're not going to win the buy box right away. You're not going to start making a huge amount of sales right away until you can start to develop that trust and Amazon starts to give you the buy box. So it does take patience. And in addition, just learning the platform yourself, learning how it works, learning which products to sell, that takes time and experience. And if you give up too soon, you're never going to get to the point where you are able to list items and know which ones are going to do well, which ones aren't going to do well. And you're not going to give Amazon enough time to really understand that you are a good seller, you're a reputable seller, you deserve to win the buy box more and make more sales because you're going to end up making Amazon more money, which is ultimately what they want. So that's the number one problem I see people making. They just give up way too early with any sort of selling on Amazon and never really give it a chance. You know, when you start any new project, you're really excited about it. You're up here, super excited, and it's easy for you to motivate yourself. But once you start putting in the work, your motivation starts to dip, especially when you aren't seeing sales right away, which is pretty typical for any new business. So that's when you hit this bottom right here. You kind of hit the bottom, rock bottom, and they call this like the valley of despair because you haven't made much progress. It feels like you haven't made much progress, rather, and you don't realize that you're about to go up. So a lot of people give up right here at the bottom, but if you push through, you've already done all this work that most people weren't willing to do, and you're pushing just a little bit further, that's when you start to rise up, and that's when you start to do well. So if you're able to push through that, that's when you can start to really start to see some growth with your business. So don't give up too easily. The second reason that I see people failing on Amazon is because of a lack of cash flow. So one of the unique challenges with Amazon is that they will hold your money for 2 weeks. So in other words, let's say you sell $2,000 worth of products today. Amazon isn't going to give you that money today or tomorrow. They're going to wait 2 weeks before sending you that money. For most business owners, that's a challenge when it comes to cash flow because you need that money to add inventory back into your store in order to fulfill orders if you're a drop shipper. So what do you do in the meantime? Well, the best solution is to get a really good credit card with a high limit, especially if it's one that gives you cash back or reward points. That's the best solution. Then you put the inventory on the credit card, and then once Amazon releases the money, you pay off the credit card. Unfortunately, that option isn't available to everyone, either because they're a new business and don't have the credit yet, or their business has grown so much that they just don't have enough space on their credit card to fulfill all their orders or to add more inventory to their stores. And that's where the sponsor of this video comes in, Payability. What Payability does is they will advance you 80% of your earnings every single day. So just for ease of math, let's say you sell $100 worth of products today. Payability is going to give you right away $80, 80% of that. The other $20 you're going to get in 2 weeks when Amazon releases the money to you. You can then use that money to fulfill all your orders, to add inventory back into your business, and just keep the momentum going for all the sales that you've been receiving. Now, Payability does charge a fee, but that fee goes down as you make more sales, as you use them longer. And they also have another service, which is a cashback credit card. I think it's 2% back that they give you. So that offsets the fee. So effectively, if you use that credit card along with their service, it's pretty much a wash at that point. So if you are interested in signing up with them, I will put a link below that you can use. And if you use that link, you will get $250 just for signing up through that link. So that's the second reason that I see people failing on Amazon. Luckily, services like Payability exist to help us through that and to help us with that cash flow issue. That brings us to number three. And number three is that people are listing the wrong items. And I kind of mentioned this before earlier in this video, but this is hugely important. If you want to do well on Amazon, you must be listing the correct items. There is a right way and a wrong way to do this. You can't just list anything because not everything sells well on Amazon. Now, luckily, Amazon tells you which items are doing well. They call this the Amazon bestseller rank. So each category has a bestseller rank for that category. Number one is the number one most popular item in that category. Number 1 million is not that popular. So you want to get a low BSR if possible. That way you know the item is selling well. You also want to check out the competition though. Obviously something with number one is going to have really high competition. So the sweet spot is an item with low competition and with the low bestseller rank. It's not easy to find, but it's also not impossible. And with more practice and experience, you will find items like this with the low competition and the high demand. Speaking of demand, that brings me to number four, which is that people aren't using the correct software when selling on Amazon. Now, one of the other unique things about Amazon is that when you sell on their platform, all of your items are grouped with other seller items as well. So when people check out an item, they'll see that you're selling it, and they'll also see the three or four, sometimes 20 other people that are also selling that item. So logically, they're going to buy from the cheapest one that's available, as long as they have, you know, a good reputation, a good rating on Amazon. So what you can do to help yourself be more competitive on Amazon is use a software called Informed. Informed used to be called App Eagle. And what works so great about it is that it will constantly lower your price if you wanted to undercut your competition or to match your competition. So you'll always make sure that you are as competitive as you can be. Now, it won't price it so low that you'll lose money. You set it up with all these algorithms to make sure that you don't lose money on your sales, but it will keep lowering it until you hit the lowest price that you're willing to sell it for. So software like that is really critical to use to make sure that you are being as competitive as possible on Amazon so that people actually buy from you instead of just skipping over you and buying from another seller. Before we get to number five, if you guys are enjoying these tips so far, please give the video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. Also, if you want to check out a free mini course I have all about Amazon dropshipping, that will be linked up below as well. And that brings me to the last one, number five. The fifth mistake that I see people making when they're selling on Amazon is that they're trying to do it all themselves. Look, you've built an Amazon store. You are a boss now, so start acting like one and build a team. Even if that's just one virtual assistant that you hire that maybe lives in the Philippines. So you only have to pay them a few dollars an hour, which is a good salary for them, and it's a good deal for you. They can help you answer customer questions, list items, do order management, all those things. It saves a lot of time for you, frees up your time so you can spend more growing your business. I don't see enough people doing this, and when they don't do it, it hinders them from really growing their business. So those are the top five mistakes that I see people making when they're selling on Amazon. But I would love to hear from you. If you think there are any that I missed, any mistakes that you see people making, leave them in the comment section of this video. And like I said, guys, this is sponsored by Payability. If you wanted to check out them and get that $250 offer, that will be linked up down below. Otherwise, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.